Okay, in the last video, we looked at Koala, a dialogue model for academic research. And while they've got a demo up that you could try for this, I wanted to put it together in a Colab. So here is basically a Colab that you can run for free. So this is using the 7 billion version of Koala. Remember, Koala is basically a fine-tuned version of a llama model, but tuned on a lot of chat and conversation data and a variety of other instruction tuning as well. If you're interested in that and you didn't see the previous video, go back and look at the previous video. So here, not only are we going to be able to load it in Colab, but we're going to load it on a T4, which means you can use this Colab in the totally free Colab. As long as you get allocated a GPU, you can basically run this. So you can see here, I'm bringing it in. I'm running it on a Tesla T4. We're doing the standard stuff of bringing in the llama tokenizer, llama for causal language modeling, and I'm going to be using the pipeline for this one. And then basically I'm bringing in just the tokenizer and the model itself. Now we're loading it in 8-bit equals true here. If you wanted to load the full version, you don't have to load this in 8-bit, but you won't be able to load it in full with a T4. I think you'll need a slightly bigger GPU to do that. You can see, takes a while to bring it in, but once it's in, you will be able to then look at your GPU again, and you can see that the RAM that we're using is actually quite a small amount. So even if you've got an old GPU yourself, there's a good chance you might be able to actually run this locally using this version in 8-bit. As long as your GPU will support the bits and bytes 8-bit stuff, you should be fine. Okay, so we're setting up a pipeline here. We're going to be doing text generation. We're passing in the base model, passing in the tokenizer, setting a max length. Please feel free to change these ones, temperature and the top P, repetition penalty. All of these can be, you can play around with them and see how they go. I've just got a small utility function here. It was written by a language model to help just make the text look a bit nicer. And then we're just going into the generation. And you can see that, okay, one of the big issues that I had getting this working was actually not the technical things at all. It was just that this model really relies on this prompt at the start. So this prompt where you say beginning of conversation and then user, and then you pass in what the user is going to say is crucial. I encourage you to try it without it, and you'll see that it's very hit and miss without it. In fact, so much so, like there's a question I put down here, what is the capital of England? And when I put this in, it gets it perfectly correct. When I don't put this in, it goes in a whole different direction. So it has been reading their docs and stuff like that. This is how they basically train the model. So you need to basically put this in your prompt as you're feeding it in. We can see that, okay, asking it, what's the difference between llamas, alpacas, and koalas? It gives us a really nice list of things. And it basically goes through some the details about how they're different, etc. You can see that this took a bit of time to generate. So on the T4, you will have to wait a little bit for things to generate. Okay, the standard one that I've been using a lot lately is write a short note or write an email to Sam Altman giving reasons to open source GPT-4. This model does really well at this. It basically goes through a nice sort of coherent argument. It talks about like different parts of it and stuff like that. It's got it to paragraphs about what's going on, etc. Play around with these. It's been different each time I've generated it too. That's one of the key things. I mentioned already asking just simple questions that are quite short. If you don't have this prompt part here, you'll find that it tends to not do very well at all. Whereas if you do, suddenly you get this nice key answer. Another interesting little observation for you too is that just putting the new line character at the end there totally changes how the model reacts. So if I don't put a new line character there, it will basically not have this word answer here. It will just basically treat it like it's a conversation. If I put the new line character there, then I tend to get either the word AI colon or answer colon. My guess is this is basically because they've trained from different things on different data sets there. Here's another one. So this Koala has been trained on story writing and poem writing and stuff like that. I asked it to write a story about a koala playing pool and beating all the camel lids. I do think that this is probably better than a lot of the other camel lid models that we've played with. And sure enough, here you notice that I didn't put the the new line character at the end, and it basically then we don't see like an answer or anything like that. We just see what we wrote, and then it goes into generation. Once upon a time, in a far off land where animals could talk, there lived a koala named Coco. Coco was known for his love of playing pool and his exceptional skills at it. One day he decided to challenge all the other animals in the kingdom to a game of pool. And then it basically goes through and talks a bit about Lola the llama, Cammy the camel. I don't know if it's got an alpaca in there. Maybe we should have told it to put that he beats an alpaca as well. But you can see, again, very coherent text, interesting results, stuff like that. So experiment with this as well. Finally, the last one was I wanted to basically ask it about to see how much sort of safety stuff is in it. We looked at this in the last video. There is quite a bit of that in this. So if you're not a fan of that, and I know from the comments some of you are not a fan of that, experiment. We can definitely fine tune on things that don't have that if you really want it to. As an AI, do you like The Simpsons? Okay, its response is, as an AI, I don't have personal preferences or feelings. However, I can tell you, because I asked it a little bit about, and I spelt it wrong, I asked it a little bit about Homer. And I can tell you about The Simpsons is a popular animated TV series, tells us good some nice facts about it, and then tells us a bit about Homer in there. And he is known for his catchphrase and his love of beer. So on that note, I think I will leave it and I encourage you to play it. Write your responses of anything you notice really interesting, please write it in the comments. I was definitely surprised by just how much a new line character can really move this model, whereas that isn't the case for a lot of the other models. And then also you could experiment with some other sort of beginnings of prompts and see what you can do with the various kind of prompts as well. Anyway, as always, if you have any questions, please put them in the comments. If you found this video useful, please click and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.